Sold out. What sold out? New homes. Is this real? It is with a lot of builders. New construction used to be a great option and still can be, but you need to know that the rules of the game have changed. Wait, what? Help me understand, Angie. Let's talk about new construction and what's happening. Hey y'all, Angie Ufomata here, Realtor with Norwal & Company in the beautiful Austin area. Let's dig right into new construction. We've seen a shift in the new construction market in the last few months. This was my alternative and go-to for clients who were exhausted from the resale market. They were tired of multiple offers, bidding over asking, steep competition, and turning up empty-handed with no house. New construction used to be the way to open up a door for my clients so that they could actually win and get the home of their dreams. That still can be true, but things look a little bit different than before. I'm seeing builders' processes and rules change so much and so fast that it's almost hard to keep up. Why is this happening, you ask? Because of extremely low inventory and high buyer demand. More and more home builders are sold out, not just their inventory homes, which are ones where builders design everything and then put it on the market, but I'm talking about lots where you're going to build your own home. Those are also sold out as well. Buyers are looking for alternatives outside of the city, and they're turning to new construction. The idea of having the opportunity to purchase a home and buyers getting what they want is more and more attractive. So with so many flocking to the suburbs, builders became quickly overwhelmed. So we started to see new practices come into play, along with some ones that we've seen before. First up, lot bidding. This is new and similar to what we see in the resale market. It used to be that you could find a builder in an area you loved, chose a floor plan that worked for you, and select a lot to build on. To secure the lot, you put down a deposit, and then the contract was sent. Unfortunately, this scenario is rare these days. Now with lot bidding, the builder has a limited amount of lots that they are selling to buyers, and those lots you'll put an offer in on, which does not include the base price of the home. Here's an example of how it's played out. I have a client that loves a particular community and builder. We are currently waiting for new lots to be released. When they are released, they will select a few options in terms of lots they like, along with some floor plans, just in case their favorite floor plan can't be built on a certain lot. The builder will send out a suggested minimum bid for each lot. The minimum starting price can range from $10,000 to $120,000. Of course, there's an extra premium for lots with a view, a cul-de-sac lots, and greenbelt lots. Buyers will have to decide how much they would like to offer on a lot and submit the offer to the builder. Some builders do allow you to offer on multiple lots to give you a greater chance of winning, but others you only can offer on one lot at a time. Once you succeed and you are under contract, be aware that along with an earnest money deposit, the builder may require that you also put down the amount you offered over asking. So if the asking price is $300,000 and you offer $310,000, you'll pay the earnest money deposit. On top of that, you'll also add the overage, which is $10,000. Also know that even if the builders are not doing lot bids, they are capping the amount of homes that can be sold each month. I'm seeing extremes as low as 2 homes per month. A lot more builders are offering inventory homes only. I received a message the other day that said that a builder has stopped all sales temporarily so that they could build inventory homes. What does this mean for you? You won't be able to pick out all of your finishes in the home, and you won't be able to select a lot to build on. The builder will make all of the home selections from structural options to cabinet color. Now, this can seem limiting and it may not be for everyone, but the driving force behind it is beneficial for some. For builders, putting a halt to sales gives them time to be able to build homes fast, and not allowing buyer selections allows them to buy in bulk. It also gives them time to analyze the numbers, you know, the prices. Can't forget that one. In turn, once they've gotten to a place where they can market the home, your time to move in will be a lot quicker because they will be further along in the build process. No need to wait your typical 8 to 10 months. The downside is that you won't be able to make any selections at all, of course, and the rising prices. Next, I'm seeing a long wait list. Some builders are still doing the wait list and have not changed their practices just yet, but you may be on the waiting list for a long time. I've spoken to so many new home sales consultants, and they've told me that they have hundreds on their list, and in one area, over 1,000. Just know that you may be waiting a long time, and I would advise that you continue looking while you're on those lists. The other factor that we don't know is when lots will be released, how many will be released, and what the prices will be. There are so many unknowns, unfortunately, in this current market, and the sellers have all the power at the moment and ultimately make the decisions on how they're going to navigate buyer demand. With that said, I want you to know that you still have an opportunity to buy new construction. I just wanted to make you aware of what's going on in the market so that you're not blindsided. I'm seeing this every day, and I'm helping clients find the right community and home. What can you do to win? Make sure you have a realtor. I know how that sounds. It sounds crazy. But the truth is that we're in the field every single day, and I've built relationships with a lot of new home sales consultants. Having a realtor in your corner and keeping a pulse on the market is key to getting your dream home. If you're thinking about buying new construction, give me a call. I know almost every new home construction community in the Austin area. And if I don't know it, I know how to find it. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see y'all on the next one.